The Raceline NASCAR News Brief, your weekly quick look into NASCAR, broadcast worldwide through YouTube on the Auto Channel.
Welcome back to Raceline. I'm Tiffany Ricardo with a look at this week's news. Well, NASCAR has won their appeal over AT&T. And those AT&T logos might be coming off the car as soon as this weekend. Now, you might remember AT&T sued NASCAR when NASCAR said those logos, AT&T logos, are not going on Jeff Burton's what at the time was Singular Wireless Chevrolet after AT&T and Singular merged. AT&T sued, NASCAR filed an appeal, and now NASCAR is in the right, apparently. So we will see what happens in the future. This is probably not over yet. Well, one of the biggest stories of the week finally came out. We've been waiting with bated breath to see where Kyle Busch will be next year. And he has finally made a decision. That announcement was made last week in Charlotte, and Raceline's Woody Kane was there.
Well, one more piece of the 2008 puzzle came together this week here at Joe Gibbs Racing when Kyle Busch announced he'll be joining the team next year.
Like JD said, you know, hopefully be here for the rest of my career, and you know, it's definitely something that's been worthwhile and been waiting for and been trying to decide on. But it was an easy decision when looking at all the prospects and looking at all the decision making properties that basically you had to all sit down and put in front of you. So really looking forward to 2008 and hopefully being able to build a strong bond here with Joe Gibbs Racing and being able to contend for championships.
So in all likelihood, there's an even stronger powerhouse now for 2008 set to come out with all guns blazing, running for championships. In Huntersville at Joe Gibbs Racing, I'm Woody Kane for Raceline.
So now the question remains, will Joe Gibbs go with Toyota next year? That rumor keeps getting new life in the Nextel Cup garage. We heard more about it last week at Watkins Glen. Well, Gibbs may be thinking about going to Toyota, but evidently DEI and Richard Childress Racing are set to stay with Chevrolet. And Hendrick Motorsports has definitely said they will be with Chevrolet for at least the next 5 years. So if Gibbs does end up going with Toyota, that'll be huge for the Japanese automaker after a tough first year in Nextel Cup Racing with Michael Waltrip, Team Red Bull, and Bill Davis Racing. Well, elsewhere, Petty Enterprises is planning to keep Bobby Labonte in the number 43 Dodges next year. There were rumors flying around for a while that Bobby may be headed to a fourth car at Richard Childress Racing, but that looks like it's not going to happen now. He'll be staying put at Petty Enterprises. So one of the only remaining pieces of the puzzle to fall into place is the number 8 car at DEI. Several names apparently on the top of that list include J.J. Yaley, David Ruderman, Greg Biffle, and Mark Martin. We should be hearing more on the 8 car in the next week or so. And the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company raised $20,000 for the NASCAR Foundation and its driver-operated charities by letting fans bid on tires that were individually signed by all 43 Nextel Cup drivers. The top 5 bids went to tires signed by Tony Stewart, Juan Pablo Montoya, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Jamie McMurray, and Elliott Sadler. Well, that's a look at the news for this week. I'm Tiffany Ricardo. More Raceline coming up right after this.
Enter to win a day at Ford Racing High Performance Driving School at Miller Motorsports Park. Here's your chance to drive one of our 340-horsepower Mustang GTs on a world-class racetrack. Enter to win at FordRacingEvents.com/MMP. More of today's show right after this.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to catch the full Raceline show each week on your local TV station and worldwide on the AutoChannel.com.